Butler household, we celebrate a little differently. That's been happening a lot more lately, thanks to Educators Credit Union and their new Mind and Money tool. Now we can easily assign chores and the kids can pay for them right away. We can track their earning and spending and even reward them for making good grades all through our phones. So they're learning valuable financial lessons and I'm getting a clean house.
Learn more about the Mind and Money tool at ecu.com.
That was all. Please, bitch, ain't talking about heat. Put it on. Screw it. Screw it. Screw it. Screw it. Screw it.
Ooh. That's why I picked the music for this show. Welcome to the Elite 36.
Who is this?
I ain't never heard Cardi B. To me, now this is just my opinion.
That's Cardi B?
That's Cardi B.
Who's she with? Offset?
She with her husband.
Who's Offset?
Yeah,
Offset.
That's her husband.
Offset?
They did. Yeah,
is that her husband? Offset?
Doing anything for clout.
Clout chasing.
Is that her husband? Offset?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who? Who the one girl with?
Which one?
That did the Super Bowl halftime.
Jay-Z?
No.
Rihanna, Travis Scott.
Rihanna?
Who?
Travis?
Who,
no.
Who Rihanna with?
No.
A$AP Rocky.
A$AP.
Yeah, yeah.
What's who's the difference between A$AP and...
And take and what? Offset?
Yeah, they...
What's the difference?
They same people?
No,
they're not the same people.
Oh, okay. Different
are you doing that for comedy or you really don't know?
Well, what's the guy name that got like... 10, 12 baby mamas. That could be true. What's
Nick Cannon?
Nick Cannon.
Nick Cannon is a rapper.
Well, he...
Well, he's a rapper.
Okay. Yeah.
But the reason why I wanted that doing anything for clout, because Ja Morant clout chasing.
Why are you doing that?
You tell me. Now, wait a minute. I'm going to say this. Okay.
Say this and say that?
They ask you a fair question.
Okay.
This is a very fair question.
All right, come on.
He's from... No, I take this way. He's from South Carolina.
Okay. That's still the dirty South.
Well, it's the South.
They're on
dirty.
The coast.
But it's South.
They're on the East Coast. Folks forget about the South goes, you know, you talk about Tennessee, South Carolina, North Carolina, you know.
Yes. Went to school at Murray State.
Folks forget about Savannah, Georgia's right there on the coast, too.
That's true.
Folks forget about
that's
that.
In Kentucky, but he played in Memphis.
Right.
Okay. I'm going to get into my story later.
Okay.
Why weren't you clout chasing when you grew up? Where were you going?
See, here's what I don't understand.
You want to see the context.
Well, I'm going to ask you this.
Because they said the culture. What is this culture called?
I'm going to ask you this.
I'm asking you a question.
Well, I'm going to ask you this too, but maybe it's changed, Leroy, how these kids growing up now.
He ain't no kid, but I know what you're saying. Go ahead.
Well, I'm 60.
If so he's 25. To you. I'm a kid to you. I get it.
Yeah, if he's 25, then he.
Yeah.
Because I got children older than him.
Yeah. So do I.
Chilling.
My oldest daughter's 38.
See what I'm saying? So he
kidding. That's like my second time Mario getting it in and had a baby. Go ahead. Hey, man. I wasn't getting up because at 17, man, that feeling, I wasn't moving. Go ahead, man.
You ain't use no rubber?
Where you get that from in the inner city? You go to the clinic for the shot. You ain't go there for no rubber. And you say condom. You don't say rubber. That's disgusting.
Well, I don't know where you grew up at, but where I grew up is jokes ask you for a rubber. They ain't ask you for no condom.
Okay.
I don't know where you from.
But I was just I'll tell you in a second. Rubber.
Now, where were you? Mario.
Tell the people where you born.
Condom or rubber?
Semantics.
Huh?
Rubber.
Okay. Semantics.
There ain't no semantics. I'm just saying where I grew up. That joke, man, you got a condom. I mean, Joe couldn't even pronounce condom.
Yes, you could.
No, he did not. Not where I'm from.
Which one more sexier?
How about this?
Condom.
Yeah.
We weren't doing sexy.
Rubber was the one that you put on Mario. And they bust on you.
Mario, come on. Was you doing condoms? We weren't doing rubbers. No rubbers, man.
Listen, I got seven kids. I know the difference.
No, you don't know the difference.
Yeah, I do.
No, you don't. If you got seven kids, you don't know the difference.
Hey, man, what?
Right now.
Hey, man, just like at the bank.
You don't know.
Don't you like to withdraw at the bank? Same thing.
Jokers been busted. Jokers bust on you.
Yeah, rubbers bust. Condoms don't.
Same thing.
Cement. Shout out to Trojan. Come sponsor us.
What kind you use?
It didn't matter.
Did you ever use a French tickler one?
No, I ain't trying to tickle nothing. I'm trying to get them 4 or 5 minutes and get out of there, man. I'm 17, 18. What are you talking about?
I ain't use no condoms, man.
Man, talk about where you from.
All right, anywho. Things must have changed from the way we grew up, Leroy. I don't know. And you talk about it. You know, you're from the projects.
The worst of it, worst.
Blasio Homes.
Yeah.
I get it. But where I was from, Leroy, dudes that were... athletes?
Put that down, Mario.
Athlete.
Yeah.
Dude that was athletes?
Yes.
The game boys, dope boy, drug boys, whatever it was, shielded.
That's a fact.
Me from
true
that.
True fact.
They looked out for me. They knew my nickname was Bump.
Yeah. Bump. Oh, he sold drugs. If his name Bump.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry, Mom. You're finding out now he's 60. But he sold some of that stuff. That butter.
We can't let Bump get in trouble.
Right.
Not happening.
The streets protected you.
Right.
Yes.
Not happening. And wouldn't let me do stupid stuff, even though I wanted to. Like at 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, Bump, you got to go. You got to go home, bro.
The street lights should not catch you.
Yeah, you got to go, bro. Mm-mm. You got to go home. So.
That's true.
I don't know. Back to Ja Morant now.
Yep.
Has it changed? Because these dudes videotaping him.
Well, they live. I mean.
Live or not, but your boys who you running with knows that you can't be getting in trouble. They protected me. They should be protecting him.
Yeah.
But I don't feel like it's that way no more. I don't know.
It ain't up to the friends, but I'll wait.
But that was, that's what I'm telling you. Where I grew up, them dudes were my friends. We went elementary school and kindergarten together. Yeah. Hansel and Gretel, kindergarten. We went to first grade together. We went to middle school together.
Hansel and Gretel?
Yeah, it's named kindergarten. Hansel and Gretel.
Yeah. In Georgia?
Yeah, Hansel and Gretel.
Okay. So girls went there too?
Yeah. Hansel and Gretel. Do you know? Was Hansel and Gretel, what was that, Mario? You remember that? Was that a...
He wasn't born from when he knew Hansel that was hot.
Was that a story tale or what was
that?
Yeah,
Hansel just go, come on with the story. Mark, you asking a guy 17 what about stuff. He don't know that.
Well, he knew what rubbers were. He don't know what comes. That's my part, Mario, man. I like Mario, man. Oh.
Don't follow this guy.
I like Mario a lot, man. Hey, but anywho.
Yeah, so they protected you.
Protected me, Leroy. I don't
from yourself.
From myself.
Yes.
Or from any other outside entity.
Yes.
Is that not happening anymore? That's what I don't get.
Well, when
that's my question to you.
Okay, I'll answer that first, and I have one for you, because I think that they also, did you have an entourage? Like 8 or 9 guys always with you in the locker room?
No. Well, the 8 or 9 guys that was always with me was...
Non-players. I'm saying non-players.
No non-players.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
No.
So my story is well documented, but I'm doing a documentary on my life story. And in talking to the filmmaker, one of them actually, Patrick Creighton, I'm from the Blasio Homes that was so bad, Mario, they tore it down. Crime every day. Okay. Poverty, everything. And Gary's right. If you get home 6 o'clock on the way home and the light's about to come on, all the elders, the homeboy, the boy that's slinging that thing, you got to go home. Because you got to make it for us to say, because we something may happen to us because we hustling. Right. You ain't no hustler. You soft.
Yeah.
And you know what? Soft got me my freedom. I ain't never want to be hard. This in the inner city now, in the projects. So growing up, if I wanted to, which now my full disclosure, my wife, Second Amendment. Me, I don't deal with guns. But I don't go nowhere to where I need to have one. I have security.
Right.
Well, I mean, it's free.
Yeah.
Police, free. Love the police. Shout out to the police. So my thing, Gary, is the first time John Morant, and he ain't listening. This message is not even for him.
No, he ain't.
He's not going to care about the message.
No.
Because he would have cared the first time.
Right.
I'm just saying for the people who down with that culture, any rapper you know, and I love him, want to be John Morant. He want to be a rapper. Use your finger like Drake.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't put no guns in there. You don't see LeBron James riding down the street with a gun. And for the people to say, well, he young. No, he ain't.
Yeah.
As soon as you pay taxes, you should know better. I like young NBA young boy music. I ain't going to pick up no gun. I watched John Wick for the 50th time. I ain't going to shoot nobody. It's fake. Every rapper wants to be an athlete, and every athlete wants to be a rapper. Some of them.
Gusto.
But some of the grown men, like, man, I ain't doing that. I'm not. No. I mean, LL Cool J, these guys ain't riding around. And you look at Jay-Z. Now, this guy went from, allegedly and factually, selling to a billionaire to finna get a fender. Make it a casino.
Right.
In Manhattan.
Right. Well, them jokers are part of Death Row Records.
Rockefeller.
Rock Nation.
Rockefeller Records.
No, early on.
Well, they all worked together, but Snoop Dogg knew we were.
Yeah, Death Row. Yeah, early on. Didn't they cross over?
Snoop,
early.
Snoop is another one.
Yeah.
Snoop.
Entrepreneur.
Every time you turn the TV on.
Snoop is on there. Snoop is on
50 Cent.
With Martha Stewart.
Mm-hmm.
50 Cent.
He crossed over. Snoop crossed over big time with Martha Stewart.
Shout out to Martha Stewart. She's on the SI cover, by the way.
Now Snoop got Death Row Records.
Right.
But I'm just saying, these guys, look at these guys. 50 Cent got shot 9 times. Mm-hmm. You don't see 50 Cent in no... 50 Cent is a businessman. Yeah. Got all these great shows. So my thing is, Garrett, we grew up... Well, you grew up... Probably a little bit better than me. Not much, but a little bit better than me. Mm-hmm. But I'm talking to the people in Shannon Sharpe's comments. Shannon, he's a Second Amendment. Stop. We have rules and regulations when we work.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Leap 36 podcast, we don't have any. But your employer said you got to do X, Y, and Z. You got to follow that or go somewhere else and get $197
million. It's $231
million. Well, he could have made that if he wasn't suspended for the All-NBA. Right, Garrett. Put that in. Yeah.
$231 million. He won a waiver gun.
And I just think that.
That's true. Like, it wasn't on his lap or nothing. Like, you want to pull it out.
But, but see, and go back to what Garrett said. His friends, man, don't even bring that gun.
Right.
Right.
Why are you don't bring it? Know not to.
We're going
to
go live.
Right.
Get rid of that hammer, dog.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Okay, what my God.
At the first incident, I went and nobody next to me found live. Next to me
nobody going live. Nobody.
Before you go live, you got to check your surroundings.
No, they should know that. His boys
got to
should know
coat.
That.
Man.
Them the dudes, if they don't know that, they shouldn't be with you.
But do you agree with me? You don't blame the music or you don't blame the movies?
Here's the thing, Leroy.
If you're influenced by that,
some people are, though.
You might as well stay in the basement.
Some people are.
Some people are, but
people are influenced.
I don't blame the music
by that lifestyle. Some people are influenced.
Oh,
by
well, that's obvious. So you're right. It's obvious. You're right. They are influenced.
Some people
by
it. Are influenced by it.
You ain't supposed to be.
You ain't supposed to be, but some people are.
You
influenced
are 100%
by
right.
That lifestyle,
because you're grown enough to know that.
Like infatuated.
These, infatuated with that.
Young Thug. Love Young Thug music. I was telling Gary about it. Got in that RICO case?
Yeah, because they're listening. They're watching.
Drill music and all that. I mean, listen, guys.
They're telling on themselves.
Right? These guys wish they were John Morant.
Yeah.
They don't have to do that. Because what you sing about, you don't have to be about that life. No. That life is what white people sit around and say, look at these ignorant black kids.
Correct.
You got $200 million, you fool.
Yeah.
They can't say it out loud.
But they saying it.
But they saying it.
In their group.
In our culture, that's saying, man, y'all too, man, that's beat down.
No, you got two different.
No, I ain't trying to do that.
Here's what I'm saying, though.
I ain't trying to do that.
You got about two or three different factions here right now.
Factions, put that down.
Factions.
Yeah, put that down.
One of them is, what did Ja Morant do wrong?
Okay.
He should be able to carry a gun if he wants to. He should be able to wave the gun if he wants to. What did he do wrong? You got that faction of people.
Yeah, Second Amendment. Yeah,
you got that faction of people.
Yeah.
And then you got the faction of people who you just talked about.
Yeah, our people.
Our people. Why y'all coming down on him like that? He's just out having fun. You have those.
I mean, they look turned up now. I mean, they look turned up until the gun come up. Hey,
that got stopped to a halt.
Whoa. Because I'd have been in that with him like,
right.
Put me out. Just like Ricky said.
And then you got the faction people who you were just talking about. And I hate to make this racial or anything like that, but sometimes it can. But
you were born.
But then you got a faction people.
Yeah.
Who are white people or Caucasian people who are saying they just don't understand. You got $231 million, never seen generational money. What are you doing?
Right.
Well, yeah. Generational wealth. And here's the thing.
You're right.
Most folks like to talk about broken homes. He got both of his parents with him.
Facts. Yeah. Hey, didn't allegedly, his mom got in a disagreement at a shoe store?
A young man came up to her and it was a disagreement.
She calls Ja. To come up there, he come up there with some of his boys. The guy got to be locked in like a thing. What is that? I mean, you got out of all this stuff. You got past it. For a guy, I can speak on this big time. For a guy that has therapy every week, one time a week, okay, invest it. You have to invest in yourself. If you're going to buy a new car, invest in your mental health. When they said he went to therapy, and got out in about 10 or 15 days, I said, you don't go to therapy one time, you stay there.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you're in there with these therapists, you can't lie to them. And they're going to know about it. Like, somebody talk to. To keep it 100 with you. I said, something ain't right. But I was saying about Ricky. Remember in the movie?
You're Ricky Smiley?
No, man. Ricky from the
movie. What are
you talking about? What, Ricky? With Ice Cube,
man. What movie is that?
With Ice Cube. Remember Ice Cube with the gun and Ricky say, pull it over, let me out.
What's the name of the movie?
Boys in the Hood.
Boys in the Hood.
Okay, yeah.
Let me out.
Yeah, let me out. Yeah.
You going to shoot these marks.
Yeah.
That language, I can't speak it.
Yeah. That
Ricky say, let me out.
Yeah.
I'm going to USC.
Yeah. Yes.
Let me out of the car.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And the only reason why I'm saying this is, and I know people, I've been hearing a lot of people talk about it, which is good. It's a good conversation. But we didn't think you would be having it with Ja Morant.
You would have thought.
Again.
Yeah.
Not again.
But I'm not going to blame nobody, but one of the best songs of one of my favorite singers.
What's that?
Man in the Mirror.
Oh, Michael Jackson.
Mike. My mom told me this. Yeah. This is the reason why I'm going to do a documentary on my life.
Mm-hmm. My mom. Am I going to be in there?
At some point.
Okay. Mario, you got
regrettably.
You got Mario.
But the good thing about me, I have Mario. Final editing. So if you say something, I can whack you out.
You got Mario spot.
You got other
people. This ain't going to be like the Michael Jordan thing where I'm going to be mad at you.
No, I don't talk about nobody but myself. Okay. I ain't got nothing to ask to grind. Every day for me is a vacation.
You're doing a documentary and I don't get a chance to see it. Then you say, well, man,
you see it just like everybody else.
He the one did it. I ain't have nothing to do with it. They just put it out. I just, you know what I mean?
No, I have final editing.
Okay.
Doubles. They don't even look
like that. Yeah, right. You know what I mean?
No, it's not a movie. It's a documentary.
What's the difference?
And there's nobody that look like this.
Okay.
Nobody. But
anyway.
It just, to me, it's just the confusing thing. But she used to always tell me about yourself.
Yeah.
I don't know if I ever shared this story. Well, I do at Butler versus Bullying when I go to schools. 13 years old, I had no friends, and I kind of wanted to fit in with everybody. Right. Gee, I mean, I didn't have any friends. Some of the guys from the neighborhood, they say, hey, man, we're going to the store. You want to go? I said, wow, it's a great opportunity. Great.
Yeah, we go to the store.
And it was only like a mile away.
It's the corner store, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, corner store.
My mom gave me $2, which is a lot of money. Yeah. So I went there and got some marbles, you know, because we play marbles.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you got some annihilators.
You know, I get only grape, though.
Okay.
So is that
Mark, you know about annihilators?
Yeah,
you know annihilators. That's my favorite kind.
Get stuck to your teeth.
I love them, though. I love them. So I get my stuff, and they staple the bag shut. Staple the bag shut. So I go and wait for the guys, but I don't see them. So all of a sudden, a couple of minutes later, Gary, I see them coming down like the corridor, like the aisle. Mm-hmm. And they look like they picked up a little bit of weight. I said, what's going on? So I said, and it still didn't dawn on me what was happening. So I said, wait a minute. I got my bag and my receipt, and they stapled it back then, so they know you because you won't shoplift.
Right.
I'm sitting there.
The brown bag.
Yes, exactly. And heck on the guys. And the security grabbed both of them. Everything they were stealing fell out. I gets up. I said, I'm out of here. They stealing. I start walking out. Mm-hmm. And one of the cashiers said, that young man came in with them. I said, yes, I came in with them. But here's my bag and my receipt. And they said, call the police. I said, what? Call the police? Yep, call the police. The police coming. And Gary, you know I'm scared of elevators. Mm-hmm. You know I'm claustrophobic. I see a van drive up, look like a cage where they have animals in it. Mm-hmm. And you see like five rows, and it's full of kids. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, what's going on? Well, you got to go to the Justice Department, Juvenile Justice Department. I said, for what? And they got to handcuff you. I said, what? I said, I got my bag. I didn't steal anything. Mm-hmm. And the guy said, the police officer, who was very nice, he said, you're just as guilty if you're with these guys. I've taken these guys down all the time. Why are you with them? I said, I just came to the store with some guys, you know, no big deal. Okay, we'll go down to the Justice Department and figure it out. So now I'm panicking and I'm crying because I see that van. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Happy Mother's Day to every woman in the world. A lady who was the supervisor said, don't put him in there. Let him ride up front. Thank you, God. I don't know what would have happened if she'd have put me back there.
Well, they took a candy for sure.
I mean, I still had my bag. I'm glad you brought it up. I got my bag.
They got them now later.
The supervisor said, give it to, I'll give it back to you because legally it's yours.
Right.
Let him ride up front. But the police officer was like, well, that ain't the rules. Mm-hmm. Supervisor, he ain't doing that wrong. We ain't no bad kid. He ain't
He ain't the one.
So the guy let me sit up front, gave me the speech. And then we get there, Gary, we're going in there, and it just really changed my life because I saw these little windows, little heads bobbing, these small rooms. That's where they put you till your parents come get you. My mom was on the way. So she said, okay, I'm finna go. I'll see you later. So she left. So now it's a new supervisor, but I don't know what's going on. Mm-hmm. So they're processing you. So I'm about to just faint because I see these little cells. Mm-hmm. I mean, Mario, I'm serious. I still can feel like my skin crawling. And I'm about to pass out. Mm-hmm. And the guy come up, he says, we called your mom. She'll be here in 15 minutes. But you got to go in the cell for your safety and for our safety. Mm-hmm. I said, sir, I can't get it. Because sometimes you rub, say what you're not going to do, you don't got no rights no more. Right. You gave that up because you're a criminal.
Right.
You gave that up.
Correct.
You made a choice to be with some bad guys. Mm-hmm. You got to go in there for 15 minutes. So now the guys are, oh, you soft. You could do 15 minutes. I've been in there for a year. I said, listen, that's you.
Mm-hmm. Right. Everyone's built up.
Another young lady, she come down, head administrator. Mm-hmm. He ain't got to go in there. Let him sit at my desk. God is good.
all the time.
My heart is outside my chest. I'm panicking. So my mom comes through there. And sometimes, in some cases, you'd rather call the police than your mom.
Well, back then you did.
Right?
Back then you did.
Oh, yeah. They take the flip-flop off and throw it at you. Ain't no child abuse or nothing. Yeah, just, you know better.
Yeah.
So we go home. And then I go to court. Long story short, go to court. I stand in front of a judge. I've never been inside of a courtroom. And the judge say, nobody ever know this story unless you tell it. Just don't get in no trouble. It's sealed. No big, because you, I don't, they ain't got nothing to charge you with.
Yeah.
Accessory to what? You didn't steal anything.
Right.
So they'll probably lose the case.
Mm-hmm.
And the state attorney, they say, we don't even need to waste our time with him.
Mm-hmm.
This is why I love teachers. Three of my teachers came on my behalf. Eighth grade teachers sitting. And they wrote, he's a great kid.
Right.
He just want to be hang with people and stuff and got caught up. Mm-hmm. Never got in trouble again. So my thing is, that's why I was scared to have friends growing up. Because I need friends. Like, if I'm messing up, Gary going to keep it 100.
Yeah.
Whether I like it or not.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Mario going to keep it 100. Yeah. So, before we move to Joy and Love, I do want to say one more thing about this, Gary. And I want you to finish it. I just want people to know, just because you're from a certain situation don't mean it's going to be all terrible. I'm from a single-parent home. Just my mom raised 5 kids. So if somebody tell you a statistics of single moms, of kids not being in criminals or whatever,
right.
It's not true.
Right. And John Moran is the opposite of that. Got it's both his parents.
It's a lot of two-parent kids who are sitting in jail.
Exactly. There is.
So I don't know why you dumping on single moms. Mm-hmm. My mom did all she could. Mm-hmm. Why be with a guy that's not going to do what you want him to do?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So the thing is I think it really helped me shape my thinking being with my mom.
Mm-hmm.
So, Gary, wrap it up with John Moran.
I just think at the end of the day, it's just unfortunate. And hopefully he can see the wrongdoings. And sometimes you can't always blame your parents. So at some point, the kid got to take responsibility for his own actions.
Mm-hmm.
And in this case, Leroy, he's got to recognize the outside.
Right.
For him. And get rid of them guys on the outside who just hangers-ons, because they're not looking out for his best interest.
Right, that's a fact.
He's got to figure that out.
And I hope he,
because all the homeboys know we can't put nothing on video. Right. None can be live IG or whatever that stuff is.
And that's nothing new.
All of them know that.
TikTok.
If you ride with me, y'all know we ain't filming nothing.
Well, we did that one day to Green Bay.
Yeah, but we ain't have no gun.
Yeah, we had food. Educated Credit Union has done something to me that really brings home family values, and that's something we're talking about, is the financial literacy for kids. You know, the Mind and Money program is something I've never seen before. I really think Linda, the big boss of Educated Credit Union, should get a Nobel Peace Prize for this, because she's created a way for kids to quit asking us for money and don't give it back. You can actually do chores. If you've seen the commercial with me and my family, you can do chores, get money from your parents. You can save money, and it teach you about credit score. It teach you about everything financially you need to know. So before you go on Amazon and all these sites, do you have money for that? And it'll teach you one thing it taught my kids, the difference between wants and needs. That's huge. Do I want this or do I need it? Okay. We need the debt ceiling fixed. That's a need. Do we want it to get fixed today? It probably won't. But you got to figure out the difference. So go to ecu.com and tell them Leroy Butler sent you. And if you got any of your loan needs, make sure you go to Educated Credit Union in the southeastern Wisconsin area. But go online, too. They maybe can help you online as well. So, Garrett, Jordan Love.
Yeah, what about
his press conference?
Yeah.
He got a lot of slack for being short.
What do you mean, in stature? Or
was at his press conference, he didn't give you these long answers. He never told you what kind of horse he wants to ride. He never told you, like, what fish he wanted to eat. And he wasn't trying to be the smartest guy in the room.
He was looking for the rare beetle.
Yeah. What?
Off in South Africa or somewhere.
Pretty direct, yeah.
South, put that down.
South Africa.
Is that the same as South Africa?
Yeah, could be. S-O-U-F.
So Jordan Love has the keys to the franchise.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So what's your big takeaway of his leadership? And I would think it would start with that press conference. If you're a Packer fan, the same thing when Aaron got the keys when Brett left to go to the Jets.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think the leadership like in the offseason would be with Jordan Love running?
Well, he won in press conference if he were doing win and losing that type of thing.
Right.
I thought he did well.
Me too.
I mean, I really did. And sometimes you got to keep the answer short, direct, to the point. So I'm good with that. He saw enough of Aaron Rodgers' stuff to know what to do and what not to do. But he's got to form his own identity, so to speak, his own thing. And as he do enough of these interviews, you'll be able to formulate a plan of what kind of person he is. And I think he's truly good for the Green Bay Packers. And the Green Bay Packers will get behind, the guys in the locker room will get behind him. And, you know, I think they'll play for him. It's going to be different, no doubt about it.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to have to be his own man. And I think that's what we saw. He gets it.
Yeah.
100% gets it. Leroy, if you're with this guy and he's been behind Aaron Rodgers and all the drama that's been there for the last 3 years, you haven't heard a peep out of this man.
Nothing.
Mario,
Not one single word. He could have.
Yeah, he could have.
Now, they asked him what has been the most difficult thing for him since being behind Rodgers.
Mm-hmm.
And he did bring up, when they gave him that extension, I didn't know what to do. But you know what? He never said that during the season.
Never
brought it up. Never brought it up. So to me, I think he's been under the pressure, so to speak, a lot with Rodgers and not to say anything. And you see what type of person he really is.
Shout out to his parents.
Yeah.
Parents and family. The Love family.
Yeah.
Which we were... are going to get to know.
Yeah.
But the thing that I like is he said he was very grateful to be behind Raj to learn things.
Yeah.
He was grateful.
Yeah, he appreciative.
But you could see a young man that's finna turn into the Incredible Hulk.
Mm-hmm.
And I said the last time we had our show that I think his first year, just is my opinion, it's going to be better than Aaron's last year.
Yeah, you've said that. Yeah.
If you break it down to numbers, I went to Florida State, which is amazing. Hey, shout out to Florida State. Mike Norvell is one of the best coaches. Am I biased? Yes. But he wants that smoke.
He does.
He wants it. Throw it for what, 200 a game? That puts you at what, 3,400? So maybe he hits a 300-yard game? We went over the schedule last week. We did it with Spectrum News 1 with Dennis Krause and me and Gary.
Yeah.
And Gary made some amazing points. They be stealing my boy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So, media, when you take Gary's stuff, just give him credit.
A little bit.
You ain't even got to say Leap 36 podcast. Just say Gary Ellis. Yeah. Please.
I heard this from.
Anywho. As soon as you said something on Monday, I heard it the next morning.
Yeah.
Verbatim.
Yeah.
And they know who they are. I ain't trying to start no beast.
No,
because they got more people than we get. But we can get in there, though.
Yeah.
But to me, Jordan Love, it was refreshing to see a young man to say, I want to smoke. And everybody in the locker room was saying it. 97, 33, who I said is the face of the franchise. So my nephew, the one nephew.
In Philly?
Get on my nerves.
Okay.
He didn't want to tell
your
me about
that. Your last nerve.
He the one told me about Doc.
Oh, yeah.
He's the one that told me he just saw Gary naked on the internet.
What?
Who naked?
He said, Unk. I just seen Gary naked on the internet. I said, send it to me. Because I'm finna call Jennifer.
Oh, my goodness.
Naked.
I'm just telling what the man said, man. The man said he saw you naked.
Ain't on that naked, man.
But he was on that with his doctor getting his back together. Oh,
yeah.
And it was just a picture of his back. He wasn't naked. But what? Because my nephew is brilliant because he talk headlines. If I say I saw Gary's back, you're not going to click it. But if I say I saw Gary naked.
You're clicking.
Yeah. Click on it. And you read it. Oh, he wasn't naked.
Oh, my cousin.
But it was just his back.
My cousin Joe.
Oh, he saw it too?
Text me tomorrow.
What did he say?
Man, why are your ashy ass I hear on these socials looking like that? I said, man, ain't nobody ashy. What you talking about? People don't know what ashy means.
You better. Yeah. They know it. People know it.
Ashy.
Everybody, every culture gets ashy.
Are you ashy ass out here?
That's why they sell a lot of
lotion. I said, man, that's that iodine they put on your back, man.
Ain't no damn iodine.
They lotion it. They put that iodine on your back, man.
Hey, man, my nephew said your skin is the same color of the rainbow, cuz.
I said, man, why your ashy ass? I mean, that's that iodine. Man, don't be trying to call me out like that.
Oh my God, it's so funny. But Gary tried to get his back together.
Trying to get my back.
How you feeling? You feeling good?
Yeah, a little bit better.
All right, man. Good.
Y'all killing me.
So the headline to me is what Jordan Love is leading this team. And we talked about the schedule. They're going to be, I won the $10 from him because he claimed that they were only going to get two games, national televised game, because Rodgers is not there. I said, listen, you know I'm your favorite uncle. Mm-hmm. That G ain't never changing.
Right.
We own TV 5 or 6 times.
Yeah.
Because of the fan base.
Yeah.
And because of the franchise.
Pretty much.
We got the most wins.
It don't matter who the quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
Our stadium always sold out.
Can't get a ticket.
Other people's stadium empty.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, the Jordan Love jerseys can't find them.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't know why the young people get on my nerves.
Mm-hmm.
They want a white one. I can't find a white Jordan Love jersey. Shout out to the Packer Pro Shop. We got plenty of them, cuz. Where you going? You got to quit shopping.
Searching wrong.
You got to quit trying to get that stuff from overseas.
Yeah.
How you know?
The way they spell love with two L's.
Packers without the C. I mean, you can't do that.
Love with two O's.
Yeah, it's Pack.
Yeah.
Nah. So, but I'm just saying. So, I'm excited for him.
Yeah.
Am I putting pressure on him? No.
No.
Every quarterback Gary has pressure. All 32 of them.
Yes. All of them.
I'm just a bigger fan because I know he can handle it.
Mm-hmm.
So when they redid his contract, we talked about that. Mm-hmm. He got an extension. I thought that was brilliant.
It was.
Yeah.
I told Brian Gutekunst when I see him.
Mm-hmm.
You're the man. You're doing it on a low key.
Mm-hmm.
You handling business as... I mean, him and Martin Murphy, man, needed to be applauded. Because when Aaron Rodgers, fan, and Gary, you went through with Aaron Rodgers, people booed him. The Brett Favre people booed him. I felt bad for Aaron.
At practice.
I'm like, why y'all booing him?
They had signs.
Yeah, I'm like, why...
I don't feel like it'd be like that for Jordan Love. Yeah.
And Dennis made a great point because you lost your last game at home with Aaron. You didn't make the playoffs. If it was any landing that was a soft landing, this is it. Because now you got to go up.
Right.
And we expect him to win games. And I think himself. Mm-hmm. And I think one of my biggest, I'm a huge fan of the head coach.
Mm-hmm.
If I had any advice for Jordan Love, lean hard on the coach.
Yeah.
The coach is smart.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to give you an opportunity to do what you like. And he's going to articulate it. When you're in a game, you don't need to panic.
Mm-hmm.
I got you.
There will be some learning curve,
Of course.
Going to be some
trials. We all had learning curve.
There's going to be some of that.
Yeah.
So that's to be expected.
Yeah. So he'll be fine.
We're looking for the finished product.
You got Lake Chevy, Lake Ford ready?
Yeah, my good friends over at Lake Chevy, Lake Ford.
South Are they really your good friends or are you just saying?
Man. Dude, I've been knowing them for better part of 30 years.
Okay, right. Calm down.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
Better part of 30 years.
Yeah.
Used to work for these guys. One of my first jobs that I had right out of playing professional football with the Green Bay Packers. These guys are absolutely incredible. If you're looking for a good deal on a new or used vehicle, my good friends over at Lake Chevy Lake Ford, they have it. And it's not really about selling your car because that's service. Nice. We love it. But it's the service that you're going to get after you buy the car. A lot of people forget about it because that car is nice, new, and shiny. But at some point, you may have to go into service to get that thing fixed or changed or whatever thing like that you need. Well, my good friends over at Lake Chevy Lake Ford on South 27th Street, I think they have the best service department around. Guys, just don't take my word for it. Go check them out, Lake Chevy Lake Ford on South 27th Street.
Well, they can still take your word for it.
Yeah,
but
yeah, just go there.
Hey, what did you think when you saw Mason Crosby's wife's post?
Well, you know.
Did she delete that or
she
no?
deleted that.
Okay. Switched it up, yeah.
Yeah. I was calling Mario or texting Mario.
Or Mario. Two things can be true.
Two things. Sponsored by nobody.
Sponsored by nobody.
Well, I'm going to call him Mario.
Shout out to Union House, though.
Mario, I'm good.
Mario, can you find this? Because it was everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Did you find it?
Not when you told me, but I saw it, and then I, you know, did a snapshot, and I couldn't go back. I didn't see it again.
Right. She changed it up.
She changed it up and removed the Packer, like, being for a long time or something.
So do you think she, we're just guessing now, because we love Molly. She's family. I mean, so there's no bias here. We love, probably, because me and Gary love everybody, but it's some favorites in your family.
Right.
They're the favorites. Some of the favorites.
Yeah.
I mean, and not only that, because of the Vince Lombardi Cancer Foundation.
Correct.
We love her. So do you think she was just venting? Or because if she wanted to move the needle, it did that.
Yeah.
So I kind of applaud her.
Right.
That way.
Yeah.
I kind of do. Because nothing, you don't hear anything. It's not being signed by anybody. Well, I guess we're
I think she might have jumped the gun, though,
she
a little bit. Jumped the
gun. She was a giving a comment about.
Which is fine. Yeah. Which is fine. Here's the problem. I don't know if it's a really big problem. Mm-hmm. You know when the Green Bay Packers drafted the kicker, that may be something.
Yes.
With Mason.
From Auburn.
Coming back. And not coming back. And so, to me, the Packers would love to have it both ways if they can. I think they'd like for this young man who they drafted to come in and compete.
Yes.
And if it doesn't go right, fall back with Mason. I feel like that's what's maybe happening.
So if Carlson is not kicking well in training camp, or are you saying during the season?
I think he'll have the whole training camp to do it right. And if it's,
yeah.
if he's not right during training camp, I think Mason comes in to be the kicker.
Well,
and they keep is it his name's Carlson?
Yes.
Anders Carlson or something like that?
Yeah.
They keep him. Yeah. So, they're not going to cut him.
No, a six-round pick.
Yeah, they're not cutting them.
But you normally don't develop kickers. You draft them to play them.
No, you're right. And that's the unfortunate part about you talk about the Vince Lombardi Cancer Foundation here in Milwaukee. Molly and Mason have been the chairperson for that for a number of years. So you're not necessarily talking about what Mason has done off the on the field. You're talking about what he's been able to do within the community, which has been absolutely great. We hold the dinner at the Pfister and the golf tournaments normally at North Hills Country Club. And without Mason and Molly, we're not been able to have this golf tournament the way they've taken it on. And so for me, we have more of a vested interest in Mason because of what he's meant to the Packers and to the community of Wisconsin.
He's a great guy.
Yeah.
He's not like one.
So it's tough to see when those guys go away. You know, at some point, and you know it's going to end.
Yeah.
But it's tough to see it end.
So.
For me.
Yeah. So we'll see how that works out. But because you know, everybody was in my mention as soon as they fired Coach Bud.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Flying. You know what I said? The nerve of the Bucks.
Right.
Y'all that good where you can just fire a coach who won a championship? Then I said to myself, self, step back and look at it.
Mm-hmm.
What did you first, when you first saw it, what did you think, Gary?
Well, I thought that if you like winning the championship with Bud,
yeah,
What don't you like now?
Same system.
That's my whole hang up with this. Bud has been true who he's been the whole time. The folks changed. That's the problem I got with it, Roy. So now we're going to go and look for new coaches, which is fine. And there's some, there's a lot of nice names out there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Monte, I don't know his last name, the Phoenix coach.
Williams, I think.
Monte Williams.
Yeah, I think so.
Nick Nurse is out there. They just let Doc Rivers go. You can bring him back if you want to.
Nick Nurse, a bad boy.
I heard Mark Jackson was interviewed for the job already. So you got, you got him out there. So there's a lot of candidates.
Sam Cassell would be amazing.
Sam Cassell. There's a lot of good candidates that are out there.
Shout out to Sam Cassell.
Yeah.
Sam Cassell is going to get a job.
Mm-hmm.
Full disclosure, I went to school with him.
Mm-hmm.
Great human being. He's a teacher. He's not just a coach. So he'll get his opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
But when I first heard it, I just say the audacity.
Mm-hmm.
And then some people that I listen to that know more about basketball than me say, man, listen, if you got a, you've been winning all these games, best record, you got one of the best players, you shouldn't get beat by Miami. A play-in team.
Well, Miami beating
who's in the finals, by the way.
Yeah, Miami beating everybody.
Eastern Conference Finals.
For sure.
That ain't supposed to happen.
Miami beating
4-1.
Yeah.
And when Giannis, you got to come on the show, man. Yeah, come on, man. We on our knees begging, man. I want you to, because I think he want to say something.
Yeah, he might want to say something.
He want to just. And congratulations. I think you're having another baby.
Yeah, that's what it looked like.
Yeah.
He ain't messing around, is he?
Yeah. He got a long way to go to catch me and Nick Cannon, though. But, Giannis, you need to come on here, man. Let's talk, man. Because I know he had a post about.
How many babies you got, you say?
I got 7.
That's like a small village.
Yeah. And 6 grandkids.
Yeah, you got to claim them, too.
Yeah. You know, with grandkids, you want them to bring you the remote, you'd be like, what's your name?
They got to eat too.
G-Pa. Okay, bring me the remote.
What they
call you? G-Pa.
Who?
G-Pa.
Oh, G-Pa.
G like Gary?
Yeah.
This guy. So whoever the coach is, we're going to support you.
Yeah.
I know people are coming at me because they know I'm a big Bud fan. Yeah. Bud going to get another job. By the time we get through with this podcast and Mario brilliantly edited it, he'll have a job.
I think they were just talking about him going to the Suns or somebody else.
Yeah,
They don't like Lopez shoot threes. They're going to switch it up.
I
think the Suns
are going to move around.
But Gary, if this thing go bad and you're not one of the top teams, is Giannis going to stay?
Yeah. Because Giannis is going to have say-so who the coach is going to be. So that's why he's staying.
So if you say he has say-so who the coach is going to be, they had to notify him they were going to fire Bud.
Yes. He signed off on it.
So he maybe wanted change.
He signed off on it.
He might have just been like.
Allegedly he signed off.
Yeah, okay, fine. Yeah.
Allegedly. Because Giannis is the type of guy, I'm just playing.
Yeah, he signed off.
I ain't trying to make a super team.
Yeah.
I ain't finna go to Rutgers. Is that the park they play basketball at?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to get that mixed up with Rutgers.
I think it's R-U-C-K-E-R.
Yeah, that too. I probably could have played with them in my early 20s.
Yeah.
I ain't playing no defense, but I was a shooter.
Yeah, you better.
So, Giannis, come on the show, man. Let's figure this thing out, man. Yeah. Hey, but real quick, which one of the rookies, the Packer, I want to go back. Which one of the Packer rookies? Are you on touch with more Giannis?
Well, no, I'm going to get to this read real quick before
we
run out.
Which one
do
you want to do?
I do need... Mario, you got any soda in there? In your
soda?
Soda?
Yeah.
I don't drink soda.
You don't
drink soda?
Shout out to Jolly Good, though. Yeah. Those my people.
You got a candy bar in there?
Why you need something sweet?
You know, no candy bar?
Oh, you feeling a type of way?
Yeah.
Oh, man, we finna cut this show. This man got diabetes 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Got like a sweet cake on.
We got
some sweet cake?
Get him some sweet.
Bring me some sweet cake while I talk about
it. Get him some sugar, too.
Yeah. Bring me some sweet cake. What kind of sweet cake you got?
As long as
who made it?
What difference it make?
Yeah, perfect. Who made it?
Oh, we got it.
Is that one of them Devin snacks?
Man, that ain't a little Devin. That's a little Febby.
No.
You know, remember I sent you the one, and the guy was arguing, the kid was arguing with the parents, they don't like knockoffs.
Yeah.
He only want brand cereal. She said, you getting them Fruit Hoops.
Hoops?
You're not getting Fruit Loops. You're getting Fruit Hoops.
It wasn't coming in a bag.
Yeah, coming in a big old bag.
Big old bag. It's about 5,000 pounds.
You want to do jury? I can do jury center while you eat. How about that? Let me do jury center.
Go ahead.
Jury center.
No, don't do it. How about this?
What you want me to do?
Do the Union House.
Union House. Perfect. Mm-hmm. The Union House. Shout out to the Union House because it was a good friend of my friend Chris. He retired from Waukesha Detective Police. He's a detective. He's retired today, May 16th, as we do this. And he has a lot of friends at Union House. They're there celebrating as we tape this.
Oh, see there?
So, God, it's good. The Union House restaurant, it's in Genesee Depot, not Genesis like my wife. Genesee Depot. The Union House has been around since 1861 and has been one of the top fine dining restaurants in the southeastern Wisconsin area. It's truly amazing if you want to go to a secluded place, as my friend Chris, and celebrate. It is Union House is known for this world-class cuisine. World-class because you're going to see me.
Hold up.
Cuisine, man.
I don't feel a lot. You know what cuisine right now, is? But-
Write that down, man. Cuisine.
Yeah, I get it.
It's with a K, man.
That's a different type cuisine. Of food, I think. I'm going to have to ask the Union House about the cuisines. I'm going to have to ask them about that one.
It don't start with a C, man. Start with a K. Cuisine.
Cuisine. It's like a Q in there somewhere.
That too. He has a Q in there. World-class service and an extensive list of scotches, bourbons, wines, and one day, Leap 36. It's one of the award-winning places, man. It's really amazing. You know, I've dined there. Everybody's dined there. We have coupons or gift certificate, whatever you want to give to folks. We'll give them out one day. But check them out. If you're in the southeastern Wisconsin area, Union House is in Genesee Depot. Tell them Gary Ellison and Leroy Butler at Leap 36 Podcast sent you. And they may be able to get your, if you go there and say you got heard it here, you could probably pick your coupon up there. Mm-hmm. We'll figure that part out. Yep. So shout out to them.
Good job.
So now where you want to finish up with Bud, or you want to tell me about which rookie pack of rookie you think may have the biggest impact? Because one of these 8 or 9, 13 actually.
Good Lord,
it's going to play.
Which
one you think? You know, because I know you said one on.
I think Jaden Reed, the wide receiver.
Okay.
From Michigan State, I think he's going to get an opportunity to have a very impactful season.
Yes, because he was Randall Cobb's slot. Randall Cobb's gone, mm-hmm. So it's just him.
Just move in, Roy.
Yeah.
A return guy. Now we have a return guy, but still. Yep. You may get a chance to see him on special teams as well. So they've got a lot of rookies I think will play, but I think Jaden Reed probably is going to have the biggest impact to me on this team because I think he's also can be that specialty guy, like the move guy.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Jet sweeps, reverse, gadget guy. He's big enough where I think you can line him up in the backfield, do those types of things.
Get him out in space.
He get him out in space. So
would you play him like Debo?
Samuel. I most certainly play him like Debo because he's got that body type.
Love Debo Samuel.
He's got that body type. So to me, I think he's going to – now he's got to come in, learn the playbook and all that. Yeah. There will be no pressure. But from what I saw him at Michigan State, he can do a lot. So I'm going to go with him.
Anybody else or you just
– I'm going to let you go ahead and go.
Yeah, because I look at some of these guys, the tight end position, they're huge.
They are.
Like 6'6", 6'5". And Musgrave and Kraft, these guys are huge.
They are.
Now, I'll say this, though. Josiah DeGore is not going to get y'all nothing. Josiah DeGore, 81, smart, does switch army knife, play special teams, and the coach 11.
Right.
Okay. So,
but Josiah is different.
Yeah.
From those two guys.
I'm just saying tight end.
He's different. Though, yeah. Okay. Which they need.
Yes.
He's more like, Josiah to me is more like that kid from, is it from the 49ers? Uchek? What's his name?
Oh, yeah. I know you're talking about. Yeah. The move. I know you're
He's more like that to me.
Yeah. Yeah. Because he could play fullback.
Put him at fullback. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's good. But
the mother guy's like 6'5", 6'6".
They're huge.
Yeah.
Musgrave was a guy that didn't play a lot because he's hurt.
Mm-hmm.
And these guys are hungry. And they're gonna get he's gonna get a great opportunity. Because if you watch him on tape, I think he'll be very impactful. I really mm-hmm. do. But I mean, it would be great if your top pick Van Ness is impactful if you don't have Rashard Gary.
Correct.
But he's gonna be a situational rotation guy. But I'm talking about a guy that can go out there and catch balls in the red zone.
Mm-hmm. Red zone.
Look like Mark Chimura.
Mm-hmm.
Big target.
Yes, big target.
Sit over the ball,
mm-hmm.
there, turn, go.
Mm-hmm.
And he can do everything. Mm-hmm. So I think that's who I think will be at Gary. So we'll get a better look at him because they're up in mini camp. You right. get a chance to see him. But we got to wait to training camp to see which one of these guys. So me and Gary, we may even do a show from up there, a leap there. Can you travel, Mark?
Yeah, we can travel.
You're not, like, you don't have, like, an ankle monitor or nothing, do you?
No, I ain't.
Okay, because some of the people you hang out with, man, I don't know.
Is Mario hanging out with you? John Morant will be hanging
out? No, I won't allow that.
Yeah, okay. I'm not in the back.
I would call Carmen in a heartbeat.
Yeah, for sure.
I know his whole family.
Yeah, my mom will always say, you are who you hang with.
And shout out to your mom, too.
Yeah, for Mother's Day.
Thank you.
Yeah, I reposted that.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Yeah,
she's her birthday too yesterday. So
oh, was it?
Back to back.
Oh man,
double up,
double up.
Oh, yeah. Mom deserved that
for sure.
So Gary, my wife graduated from UW Whitewater.
Mm-hmm.
So there's the thing about. There's no doubt that people know who the smartest in our family mm-hmm. is. Her by far, and I was just proud of her because I was thinking about. I'm 54 and she's 40-ish. I ain't going back to school. It ain't for everybody.
It ain't for everybody.
Gary did it at 55 and got like 6 degrees.
Well, yeah.
But that's one thing I looked up to him because he went back. I applaud any grown man or grown lady like Gary and my wife.
Yes.
Getting a degree. I don't know how he pulled it off because he's on the radio. You're doing all this stuff. But you
no different than what Genesis did. I mean, I think,
everybody ain't built like that, though.
But those are the values that she have within herself.
Yes.
And not only that, Leroy, when you're married and you're going back to school, shout out to you as well.
Yeah.
Because you got to have your partner buy into that as well.
That's a fact. Right? You're right.
You're right. Because, I mean, because she was at Whitewater. And I remember I used to be driving up and down the highway going back and forth to Whitewater. That was a lot.
Yeah.
So shout out to both of y'all for getting that done and the family as a whole to make it happen. And most certainly for her seeing it through.
Yes.
That's absolutely incredible.
Yeah, I mean, I'm very proud of her.
That's unbelievable. Yeah. Did you wear a suit?
Of course I did.
What they call it, commencement, graduation?
Y'all suited and booted.
What they call
it? The chancellor's from Corey is from Jacksonville.
No way.
Yeah. Duval County. Finest. Duval?
From at Whitewater.
Yeah.
Chancellor. No way.
Yeah, it is.
What?
Yeah. Proud of him, man. Yeah. I couldn't meet him because I had so many people running behind me and want to take pictures. That didn't happen. I mean, Leroy.
Nobody said a thing to me. Popular. You know, you probably got.
I thought, I don't even need security. You got security. Nobody said anything. Yes. It was
security.
That's why I like Wisconsin, man. Yes. People, they appreciate. Nobody said a thing to me. I was able to enjoy it. But shout out to the young man who had to mention all those names.
Yeah.
Because some of those names, Mario, I couldn't have done it. Couldn't have done it.
Yep.
One of them sounded like 19 letters and he's.
Got it.
Hit it.
I like that.
QHZ together.
Yeah. Now, speaking of grown ups,
This
is a good way to wrap. What did you think when you saw Robert De Niro at 70 years old had a baby? Well, he didn't have the what would you call it?
He's
married, but
I'm glad you brought it up.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because if he needs to get married, he can go to the jury center.
I mean,
probably have an arrangement, right? Because I don't know if the mother can.
He could. Yeah, he could go. He
you don't necessarily have to, but if you want, you're married.
Do it right.
He can go to the jury center, right? And I know it's locally, but you can go to shoptjc.com.
You walking there 70 years old, yeah. I need a ring to get married.
Back all bent all up out shit. How I'm Vito, Mario.
Vito. Put that down.
Vito. Yeah. Vito. You go to shoptjc.com. Jurisim, catch my guys over there. They'll hook him up.
Yeah, they will.
Right?
He got plenty of cash, though.
You know he do. He can spend. He got unlimited budget. Leroy talk about budget all the time. Rob De Niro ain't got no budget. Go check my good friends out today at the Jewelry Center. Ask for their owner, Dean Murray, or go to shoptjc.com. Locally, 76 in Layton, in Layton Plaza, in Brookfield, Blue Mountain Road, and Tri-City National Bank Building. Third location for you folks in Burlington, Wisconsin. When I heard, Leroy, that Robert De Niro was having
like
a baby.
On Facebook. Too.
Yeah, like on Facebook, all the
say?
Social.
Where were you at? That was a where were you at moment.
Right. Yeah. I'm like, who the baby mama? Did anybody find that out yet?
No, I haven't seen it.
It ain't none of my business. I don't. You probably all his kids with the same mama. I mean,
Who cares?
Yeah,
it don't have to be. No, we live in a different day and time right now.
I got three baby mamas.
Yeah, but is she 65?
No, she can't be 65.
Is she 60?
No, I think. We're guessing, allegedly. I would guess she's in her 30s, 40s.
Okay.
Guessing.
Well, Leroy, that hope for you after all. Because you're talking about having another baby, wouldn't you? Marge, you know
when
this?
When you married?
When I thought about Rob De Niro and he having a baby, I instantly thought about Leroy having another baby.
I wouldn't mind having another baby. I love kids. Love them.
Here we go.
Hey, man, you're married. Day. That's a good thing about being married. It is what it is.
That's a good thing about it.
You ain't using no protection, man. You letting it go and just
shooting up the club.
What's this here? What's that?
What you feel like? That's what Robert De Niro say, man. I'm 70 years old, but I can still move. Some of y'all young boys can't be like him. Hey, man, he one of my heroes.
Shout out to Rob De Niro.
But it's a lot of people giving him a lot of slander.
Why?
Oh, he's gonna be dead when the baby is such and such. Listen,
fine. Robert De Niro.
The baby is gonna be taken care of. This man got more movies. He got assets. I don't tell people their business.
Yeah.
But stand an ovation, man. I mean, come on, man. Hey, Robert, when you ready to get the ring for somebody,
yeah.
Dean Murray will hook you up.
He gonna get him.
But I think for the most part, was split. Women didn't like it. And guys did because women
right,
were like, women like, you're gonna burden some young lady.
No, that
take
lady taken care of.
Yes, but they wouldn't have a father to take him.
He take care of
for sports,
nannies, all that.
Well, congratulations.
Congratulations, Robert.
Okay, I mean, we're not judging on this show.
No,
I mean,
no.
It ain't like Robert De Niro's in between jobs or nothing like that.
No,
exactly.
No,
I mean, he got that generational wealth.
Leroy told me a story about that one time. It's too funny, but I'm going to let it go. I want to talk about my guys, Leroy, over at Wisconsin Indoor Garden. We're actually...
Yeah, let that joke go.
Yeah, we're closed right now. But we'll open up for any special event. Like if you want to get married, if we're doing a
bachelor
party or anything that. We can open our doors and you can rent that space out. We'll open back up in the wintertime, obviously, because no one's golfing indoors. Everybody, hopefully, is outside golfing right now. But the Wisconsin Indoor Golf Center, they have stayed on with us, Leroy and I and Mario, at this podcast, and they still want to do business with us. So we'll continue to talk about it. We'll continue to promote them. But right now, we're doing just individualized stuff at the Wisconsin Indoor Golf Center. Guys, call them up today.
All right. Thank y'all very much. Tell everybody about the Leap 36 podcast. Please go download us on YouTube. What the NFL is going to be, we'll talk about that another time. I'm Leroy Butler, Pro Football Hall of Famer, and Gary Ellison, former Packer, former Badger. He does everything.
Yeah.
And we'll see y'all next time.
Thank you for listening, and please do follow us on social media. That's at Leap36Podcast to stay up to date with the latest episodes that we have coming out weekly. Please be sure to like, subscribe, share, follow, all that good stuff at Leap36Podcast. Special thank you to our sponsors, Educators Credit Union, Lake Ford and Lake Chevy, the Jewelry Center, Wisconsin Indoor Golf Center, Union House, Leap Spirits,
Leroy Butler, and Gary Ellison. Leap 36 Podcast. Available wherever you get your podcasts. When they eat up the drip and you cannot help it. Straight to a penthouse, Miami Beach. Yeah, yo. Niggas talk crazy on tweets. They don't want it because I come to defeat. They don't want it. I peep. These niggas all sweet. Bamboo sticks out in the Jeep. It's a new